Ой, блядь. This town is bullshit.
Oh, hello, friend.
Ah, yes, you have come to learn Slavic accent. Well, you are in luck, my friend. For I am best teacher for this. But my friend, this is not just quick video I'm using for likes and revenue. I am fully committed to teaching you how to do perfect Slavic accent. So get comfortable, friend. Get your kvass and get your butterbrot. This is going to be long video. But before we start, I need to tell you a few things that you need to know. I'm teaching you this so that you can pretend to be Slav. If you want real Slav accent, then you should learn Slav language, like Russian, you know, Ukrainian, something like that. But if you want to use this for fun and gaming, or maybe even acting, then you have come to the right place, my friend. With that out of way, we can get started. So, first thing you must learn is how this accent can be used. So, first thing, this accent can be used for any Slavic country, not just Russian. You can be used for like Ukrainian or Polish. Next thing, Slavic accent should include some of native language, whether it is Russian, Ukrainian or even Macedonian. Now the next thing, there are three thicknesses of Slavic accent. You can do normal thickness, which is what I'm doing now, not very thick, and very thick accent, which I will now do for you. Now first is your normal Slavic accent. This is one that I'm doing right now. As you can tell, it's not too hard to do, but not very easy. But through this tutorial, you will learn how to do this one. But this is Slavic accent you're going to be using most of the time. Next, this is soft Slavic accent. This is what actual Slavic people usually sound like. Very easy to do when starting. So this I would recommend starting off with, and then you can move on to normal. Finally, we have thick Slavic accent. Now, no Slavic man actually sound like this, but it's good for comedy. But very hard to do mentally and physically. After some time, this will start to hurt lips and cheeks. So, I'd say be careful with this one. Next, you must learn how to do your pronunciation. So, pronunciation can be a bit fucky in Slavic accent. Normally, you can be very flexible with Slavic accent, but that will just teach you basics. So, there are a few letters or sounds that you will need to have to pronounce different. R, H, TH sound, J, W and vowels, A, E, I, O, U. I will now walk you through. So first is letter R. For R's you just have to roll them. Intensity of R rolling depends on the thickness of your accent. So, first the sentence, I really like rumbas, becomes I really like rumbas. So you have to roll your R's, like in Spanish or something. Never say R, you always have to say R when doing your R's, my friend. Next is letter H. Now, for H's, you want H to be very hard, kind of like a hissing sound, like when a cat hisses. Again, intensity depends on thickness of accent. So, the sentence, that girl is very hot, becomes, that girl is very hot. Like I just did there. Again, intensity depends on thickness. Next, my friend, is letter T, H. Now, this is a sound in English that does not have its own letter, like every letter in Russian always has its own sound. Now this, there is two variants of this, soft and hard. Now some examples of the soft TH sound is this, that, there. For this sound you just want to replace that with a D sound, like this, that, there. So I have this becomes I have this. Next is the hard TH sound. Now some examples of this is theater, thumb, thought. For this sound you want to replace with like a T sound, like T. Or maybe an S sound, depending on what Slavic country you're imitating. So, I bet my thumb in poker becomes I bet my thumb in poker, or I bet my thumb in poker. Next is letter J. This you could replace with a J sound, like in pleasure, or like a crunched CH sound. So the sentence, that was not a funny joke, becomes that was not funny joke, or that was not funny joke. But usually is not as important, so you can just keep saying J. Next is letter W. For W's you should always pronounce as V, so water becomes water. And vodka always stays, you know, it's just vodka. Now sometimes you will hear people telling you to pronounce your V's and W's as V, V. This is not true, my friend, although you could and will still sound Slavic, but in most Slavic languages is always V. Now for vowels. This can be tricky for beginners because of how flexible they can be. But for now, just stick with what I'm about to show you. So A is always pronounced as A or sometimes E. So words like chapter become chapter or chapter. E must always be pronounced as E or maybe Ye. So bed can become bed. But if a E in a letter makes an E sound, keep it the same. For example, like the word eagle would stay the same. You would not say eagle or yeggle. That sounds weird. So just say eagle. Next, letter I should always be pronounced as E. So idiot becomes idiot. Unless you're saying like I went to here or I went to this place. Like if you're saying it like myself. You can always say like an I sound, but you will never say E. Next is letter O, should always be pronounced as O. So helicopter becomes helicopter. Never pronounce as A, you always have to pronounce O. Next is letter U, should always be pronounced as U. Even though there is a letter for U in Russian which is pronounced the same, you should stick with U. So puppy can become poopy, or maybe like universe can become universe. Something like that, my friends, just always say U. And finally, there are some exceptions to this, however. Some words don't have to change vowel. For example, Russia in English has pretty much no change. You wouldn't say Russia because in Russian it's spelled with an O and it is pronounced Russia. And it sounds pretty much the same as Russia in English language. So you can just keep that the same in other words like this one. You will become more comfortable with this the more you start talking with Slavic accent. First is articles. These you will never use unless reading. These include the, a, and an. So this sentence, I went to the liquor store to buy a bottle of vodka, becomes I went to liquor store to buy bottle of vodka. Sounds very Slav not to use these articles. Of course it's okay if sometimes you use articles, like me when I'm teaching this video, I use articles from now, you know, every now and then, but it's okay. Just try not to use them as much. Now, words like R and E's aren't exactly never used, but just rarely used. Not quite so much as articles, but you know, you'll learn more as you speak. So something like, why are you gay, would be, why you gay. Or something like, that is gay, would be, that gay. But you can still say R and E's, but sounds more Slav to not use. Now for your mannerisms and voice adjustments. It is very off-putting to speak Slavic accent and not use Slav mannerisms. Of course, you can go look up articles and like how to do Slavic mannerisms, but I'm just going to teach you the main ones right now. First, when talking to one person, you should stand very close to them. Not too close to them to where it's uncomfortable, but, you know, somewhat close. Never talk to someone from far away, unless yelling at them. Next, there are adjustments that you will need to make to your voice. Most people say you should make voice deep. This is bullshit. You just need to make voice sound tough. Now, there are a few ways you can do this. You can make voice raspy like Batman, but after a while this can hurt your throat. So next thing you can do is make this sound as you're talking. As if you're in awkward conversation, don't know what to say. So just try to implement this in your voice as you're talking. Now I will show you how to do this. So, if I were going to talk right now like a normal Slavic accent, I can just say, hello friend, how are you doing? But to sound more tough, you can go, hello friend, how are you doing? It sounds much more tough to talk this way, but this part is optional. Next mannerism is that you must always be straightforward, even when unnecessary. Never beat around bush or be wishy-washy. Now, if you're naturally this way, not problem. Using Slavic accent will naturally make you very straightforward. There is no choice. So say there is a guy being obnoxious. Don't kid yourself, my friend. Tell him he's being a suka. Well, my friend, that is basically how to do Slavic accent. Hopefully these tips can help you sound like big bear fighting, vodka drinking Russian man. But best tip I can give you is to, well, listen to people talking with Slavic accent, like myself when I talk. Well, my friend, just try to imitate. You will sound very stupid at first, but everybody does. I know I did, my friend. Well, I had to keep you. So with that I say, до свидания. С Москвы наркоман, с Москвы хулиган, с Москвы наркоман, наркотики куришь. С Москвы наркоман, с Москвы хулиган, с Москвы наркоман, наркотики куришь. С Москвы наркоман.